Hello dear friends, welcome to another lecture of strength of material. Now today we are going to cover the additional questions, the additional concepts of thermal stresses. We have covered already some concepts and some questions of thermal stress yesterday. Today we are going to cover the additional concepts, the concepts which you might not have seen till now. Okay, so we are going to cover those questions and those concepts. Now those of you who are watching this video for the first time, who are watching me for the first time, let me introduce myself. My name is Apuroop Rao, M.Tech from IIT Kharagpur. My specialization was mechanical systems design. Then I was recruited on campus. I worked for 2 years for Mahindra and Mahindra automotive sector. I was in their research and development center. Then I quit my job. I always had a passion for teaching. So I've been teaching for more than 6 years. For students preparing for GATE and ES, and I teach subjects related to design, strength of material, engineering mechanics, machine design, theory of machine. So you can see I've always been associated with design during my M.Tech, during my 2 years of Mahindra and Mahindra, and my 6 years of teaching. I've always been a part of design, and I guarantee you, if you watch all my videos regularly, then you will also fall in love with design, my friends. So we are posting live video lectures completely free of cost on our YouTube channel Unacademy Gate MNE. Okay, so we are posting live video lectures of all the subjects, technical, non-technical, for mechanical engineering students and for civil engineering students. So subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that you will get the notifications of all our videos, my friend. You can get benefited from all these video lectures completely free of cost. So if you are watching our YouTube channel regularly at this time, regularly 7 a.m. industrial engineering, 3 p.m. strength of material, 4:30 p.m. fluid mechanics. So we are regularly posting these live video lectures. If you are watching this YouTube channel, then you can prepare for any competitive exams related to mechanical or civil engineering, my friends. But you all know that there is a limitation for YouTube. Okay. We will provide all the videos, we will complete the entire syllabus on YouTube channel, but there is a limitation. So you will not get that classroom experience, you will not get that personalized experience. So if you want personalized experience, if you want to feel like you are sitting in a classroom, then buy a subscription of Unacademy Plus, my friend. Buy a subscription of Unacademy Plus, which is India's largest online learning platform, my friends. You can take subscription of 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, 2 year. 1 year subscription for GATE and engineering services only costs 25,000. 1 year subscription only costs 25,000 rupees, my friend. And if you use my code, this is my coupon code, APUROOP10, APUROOP, APUROOP10. You get 10% discount, you get 10% discount, instant discount. So it will only cost you 22,500 rupees, my friend. It will only cost you 22,500 rupees, means per day cost will be around 60 rupees, my friend. In 60 rupees every day, you can learn from the top educators of India. This is the biggest thing about Unacademy Plus. You take one subscription, you take only one subscription, but you can learn from any faculty who is on Unacademy Plus platform, who is teaching for GATE and ES or SSC, JEE, any competitive exams related to engineering. You can learn from any educator if you take one subscription, any one subscription. Okay, so you don't forget to use my code APUROOP10. It will be like a social currency. You can help me and I can help you. You will get a 10% discount, and in return I will get something. So it is like a feedback. Okay, if you like my teaching, if you want to learn more from me, don't forget to use my code APUROOP10, my friend. Okay, all right. So this was about my channel and Unacademy Plus. Let's move on to our video lecture. So we were solving problems of thermal stress, my friend, and last time I gave you a problem. There was a bar and there was a spring attached to the bar. Okay, so last time you are doing this problem, there is a bar and there is a spring attached to this bar. This problem was previous year question. Let me find this question for you. So there was a bar and there is a spring attached to the bar and it is heated, and we need to calculate what will be the stress developed in the bar. Okay, so this is the question. So the alpha of bar is 12.5 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree centigrade. Young's modulus of the bar is given 200 gigapascal. Delta T is given 20 degree centigrade. Length of the bar is 0.5 meter. Diameter of the bar is 10 mm. And stiffness of the spring is 50 kilonewton per meter. So this is the question, my friend. And what do you need to calculate? You need to calculate the sigma, the stress developed in the bar. Okay. So this is the question that we were doing last time. I told you to solve this question. If you have solved this question, very good. If you are not able to solve this question, let's discuss the solution, my friend. Okay. So what will happen if you increase the temperature? Okay. We have solved a similar problem where there were two bars. Okay. In this question, there is a bar and a spring, but the solution will remain same. I told you three steps to solve any problem of thermal stress. I told you three steps: free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. So let me draw the free body diagram. So if you increase the temperature, my friend, what will happen? These bodies will try to expand. So there will be a reaction force from this support like here, this, and at this point like this. Okay. So this is the free body diagram, my friend. Okay. Then what we will do? This is the first step. Second step, equilibrium equation. So apply equilibrium equation, summation of Fx equals to zero. What you will get? This force and this force will be equal. Okay. Net force in x direction should be zero. There are only two forces, so they should be equal and opposite. Okay. So this is the second step. What is the third step? Compatibility equation, my friend. What will be compatibility equation here, my friend? What will be the compatibility equation? Delta L total should be zero because both the ends are fixed. So whatever the change in length, total change in length, it should be zero. Now delta L total is the sum of delta L thermal plus delta L mechanical. What are these things, my friends? Yesterday we discussed. Delta L thermal means change in length due to temperature, and delta L mechanical means change in length due to force. So delta L thermal. Now I told you yesterday, whenever there is a bar and a spring, then in case of delta L thermal, we will only consider delta L thermal of bar. We will not consider delta L thermal of spring because it is negligible. Okay. So delta L thermal of the bar, what will it be? L alpha delta T, and it will be positive. Okay. Keep this in mind. You have to put the values with sign, positive or negative. So L alpha delta T will be positive. Why? Because temperature is increasing. So length due to temperature will increase. So this is positive. Del L mechanical will be negative. Why? Because these forces are compressive on bar and on spring. On both these bodies, forces are compressive. So let me take negative sign common. Okay. Now del L mechanical, we have to consider for bar as well as for spring. Del L mechanical means change in length due to force. So force is acting on bar as well as on spring. Both bar and spring are subjected to same force, minus P. I have taken negative sign already out of the equation. So now we will put equation for bar. So what will be the equation for bar? PL by AE. What will be the equation for spring, my friend? For spring, stiffness is given. Force is P, stiffness is K. So what will be delta L for spring? P by K. And it will be equal to zero. Both these forces will be same. This P, same. Because the bar is also subjected to P, spring is also subjected to P. So this is your equation. Now just put the values in the equation, my friend. So what is the length of bar? 500 mm. What is alpha? 12.5 into 10 to the power minus 6. What is delta T? 20. So this is L alpha delta T minus P into length 500. Area will be pi by 4 10 square. Young's modulus 200 into 10 to the power 3. So this is PL by AE of bar plus P by K. Now K is in kilonewton per meter. You can convert it into newton per mm. It will remain same. it will remain same, because kilonewton into newton, 10 to the power 3, meter into mm, 10 to the power 3. So 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power 3 will be cancelled. So kilonewton per meter is equal to newton per mm. So we can directly write 50, and this will be equal to 0. This is your equation, my friend. You can see in this equation there is only one unknown, and that is P. So what will you get? P will be equal to, solve this equation, my friend, in your calculator, solve this equation. What will you get? Those of you who have already solved, tell me the answer. And those of you who have not solved, put this value in the equation and tell me what should be the answer. Tell me what should be the value of P. You have to solve the question with me, my friend. Okay. Don't just copy whatever I am writing. You have to solve this question with me. So tell me what will be the value of P. Value of P, if you solve this equation, will be 6.25 Newton, my friend. 6.25 Newton. So we have calculated the value of P. But we don't need P. What do we need? We need stress. So stress will be equal to what? P by A. P is 6.25, and area of the bar will be pi by 4 into 10 square. It is a circular bar. So pi by 4 d square. So what will be sigma, my friend? Sigma will be very, very less, 0.07945 megapascal. 0.07945 megapascal, my friend. And this stress will be tensile or compressive? What is the force? Tensile or compressive? Tell me, what is the force? Is it tensile or is it compressive? It is compressive. So this stress will be compressive. Okay, so the stress in the bar will be 0.07945 megapascal, and it will be compressive stress. Okay, so this is the solution of the problem when a bar is attached to a spring. This question was asked in engineering services. Okay, this question was asked in engineering services. So you can see that it is an important concept when a bar is attached to a spring. Okay, all right. So we have solved some problems related to thermal stress. Bar subjected to change in temperature. Then we have solved problems where bar is at some gap. Then we solved problem where the area of the bar is different. Okay. So we have solved some problems of thermal stress. Then now we will solve additional problems of thermal stress. Okay. And my friend, you have not seen these concepts till now. You might have not seen these concepts till now. These are very new concepts that I am telling you. Okay. Most of the students don't know about these concepts. So be with me till the end, and please like this video. If you have not hit the like button, go and hit the like button right now. It is like an attendance for you. Okay, this is like an online lecture. So if you are present in this lecture, hit the like button and give me your attendance, my friend. Okay, all right. So now we will move on to the next topic, my friend. So what is the next question, my friend? Very interesting question. Very interesting question. We have this next question in hand. Very interesting question. Let's say we have a bar fixed at both the ends, but this bar is a tapered bar. Okay, it is a tapered bar, my friend. Okay, any minimum and maximum diameter are given. Minimum diameter is 25 mm, maximum diameter is 50 mm. So it is a circular tapered bar. Minimum and maximum diameter are given. Length is given. This length is 500 mm. Okay, alpha of the bar is 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree centigrade. Young's modulus of the bar is 200 gigapascal. Delta T, we are increasing the temperature by 25 degree centigrade, and we need to calculate sigma maximum in the bar. We need to calculate what? Sigma maximum in the bar. Okay. So note this question, my friend, and then we will move on to the solution. Okay, note this question and then we will solve this question. Okay, it is a very interesting question. It is a very interesting concept, my friend. You might have not solved this problem. A tapered bar fixed at both the ends. We have till now solved prismatic bars. We have solved problems of prismatic bar, constant cross section. This is a tapered bar subjected to thermal stress. Thermal stress in a tapered bar. Okay. So let's solve this question, my friend. We will solve this question with the same procedure, my friend. I told you yesterday that most of the students make this mistake. they use different strategy, they use different approach for different problems. You don't make this mistake. Use the same approach, use the same procedure for all problems and you will never get confused. Okay, you will never get confused in any question. Every question of thermal stress can be solved using the same procedure, same three steps. What are the three steps? Free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. You only need these three steps. If you follow these three steps, you can solve any problem. This is my guarantee. And I have been solving all the problems using the same three concepts. So I will apply the same concept here also. Note this question first. Note this question first and then we will start the solution, my friend. And please hit the like button. I am seeing that a lot of you have not hit the like button. Please hit the like button right now. Okay, so let's start solving this question. Now, first we will draw the free body diagram. So what we will do? We will remove the support. Okay, we will remove the support. Now, if you increase the temperature, what will happen, my friend? This body will try to expand. So there will be compressive force from here. There will be one force like this. And from here, there will be one force like this. So this is the free body diagram, right? Now, first step is over. Second step, equilibrium equation. What should be the equilibrium equation? Summation of fx must be 0. So if you apply summation of fx must be 0, then what you will get, if this is force P, this will also be force P. Both these forces will be equal and opposite, my friend. Why? Because net force in x should be 0. So summation of fx is 0. Now, third step, the final step. The entire solution is in this third step, compatibility equation. Most important step, compatibility equation. Compatibility equation. What will be compatibility equation? What is compatibility equation? We have been using this term since past few lectures. What is compatibility equation? Compatibility equation means equation of constraint of deformation. The deformation of the body is constrained. How the deformation of this body is constrained? Both the ends are fixed. So, the change in length, total change in length should be 0. This is your constraint of deformation and this equation is known as compatibility equation. Okay. Alright. So, compatibility equation, del L total should be 0 and it will be del L thermal plus del L mechanical. Okay. Yesterday, we decided that change in length due to temperature will be called del L thermal and change in length due to force will be called del L mechanical. This is what we decided yesterday. So let's put the values in the equation. What will be del L thermal, my friend? Del L thermal will be L alpha del T. L alpha del T and it will be positive because temperature is increasing. So L alpha del T will be positive. Del L mechanical, force is compressive. Del L mechanical means change in length due to force and force is compressive. So del L mechanical will be minus PL by A. No. It will not be PL by A. Why? Because it is a circular tapered bar. And in case of circular tapered bar, what is the equation? We derive the equation for circular tapered bar and rectangular tapered bar. We derive the equation for circular tapered bar. What is the equation for circular tapered bar? Change in length in circular tapered bar. What was the equation? PL by pi by 4 D1 D2 into E. I told you a simple trick to remember this equation. It is very similar to PL by AE. Instead of pi by 4 d square in area, instead of pi by 4 d square, you have to put pi by 4 d1 d2. Instead of d square, put d1 into d2. So this is the delta L in circular tapered bar due to force P. Okay. All right. So now let's put the values in the equation. The length will be cancelled. Okay. L will be cancelled. What will you get, my friend? Alpha is 12 into 10 to the power minus 6, delta T 25. Let's put this value on the right side. So this will become equal to P upon pi by 4. D1 is 25, D2 is 50 and Young's modulus 200 into 10 to the power 3. So this is the equation and from this equation you will get the value of P. So what will be the value of P, my friend? Solve this problem and tell me what will be the value of P. Solve this equation and tell me what will be the value of P. I told you sit with a calculator. I told you strictly sit with a calculator, sit with a notebook, sit with a calculator. You have to write down all these things. Okay. If I am putting so much effort into this, you also have to put effort. You also have to work really hard for me. Okay. You also have to work really hard with me, and together we will crack gate. Okay. So sit with notebook, a clean notebook and a calculator every day at 3 p.m. with me for solving problems of strength of material. Now tell me, solving this equation, tell me what will be the value of P. What will be the value of P? So it will be equal to 58905 newton, okay, or 58.9 kilonewton. 58905 newton or 58.9 kilonewton. This is the value of P that you might be getting. Okay, just put the values in the calculator and give me the answer. So 58905. Now look at this. Look at this. This bar has different area at different plane. For this plane, area is different. For this plane, area is different. For this plane, area is different. For every plane, force is same, P, but area is different for every plane. Now we need what? Sigma maximum. So what will be sigma? P upon area. Area is different. Okay, where will you get sigma maximum? You will get sigma maximum where area is minimum, my friend. Okay, it will be P upon minimum area. For minimum area, sigma will be maximum. For maximum area, sigma will be minimum. We need sigma maximum, so we will put minimum area. What will be the minimum area, my friend? From here to here, where will be the area minimum? Where the area will be minimum? From this end to this end, where the area will be minimum? The area will be minimum at left end, my friend. So P is 58905 and minimum area will be pi by 4 25 square. So if you put the values in the equation, what will you get? Sigma maximum will be 120 megapascal and the stress will be compressive. So the final answer, sigma maximum is 120 megapascal. So this is a problem of circular tapered bar subjected to thermal stress. You might have not seen this problem till now. This problem has not been asked till now, which makes it a very interesting question, which makes it a very important question, because it can be asked in gate. Okay, nowadays the professors are usually giving problems which have not been asked till now. Okay, they are giving new questions in gate. So this is a very new and very interesting question. Circular tapered bar fixed at both the ends subjected to thermal stress. Okay, so what is sigma maximum for this bar? 120 megapascal, my friend. How did we solve this question? Using the same three steps. Any problem of thermal stress can be solved in three steps. Draw free body diagram, apply equilibrium equation, apply compatibility equation. So if you follow these three steps, you can solve any question of thermal stress. That is my guarantee to you. Okay, so this was a question of tapered bar. Okay, let's move on to another question. Let's move on to another very interesting question, and my guarantee that you might have not seen this question till now. Okay, this is also a very new question. This is also a very new question. Most of you might have not seen this question, this type of question. Okay, so we are going to solve another very interesting question related to thermal stress. So be with me till the end of the video and I will guarantee you will see concepts which you might have not seen till now. Okay, so we will cover this question. Let's say we have a bar fixed at both the ends. We have a bar fixed at both the ends and it is subjected to an axial force in between the ends. Okay, let's say this is A, this is B, this is C. This force is 10 kilonewton. Okay, so let's say we have a bar fixed at both the ends and it is subjected to an axial force of 10 kilonewton. From A to B, distance is 200 mm. From B to C, distance is double, 400 mm. Okay, so do you understand the diagram, my friend? It is fixed at A and C and there is an axial force at B, 10 kilonewton. Distances are given. What else is given? Area is given. area of the bar is 200 mm square. Young's modulus is 200 gigapascal. Alpha is 10 to the power minus 5 per degree centigrade. And we are increasing the temperature of this body, my friend, by 50 degrees centigrade. We are increasing the temperature of this body, my friend, by 50 degrees centigrade. And what do you need to calculate? You need to calculate the reaction at A and reaction at C. What will happen due to this force and due to change in temperature both? There will be some reaction at A, some reaction at C. Okay, so the reaction forces will be developed due to two things. Due to this force as well as due to change in temperature. So this is another very interesting question. What is new about this question? Till now, in every problem, there was only change in temperature. Okay, whatever problem we are discussing in thermal stress, till now, there was only change in temperature. But in this problem, there is change in temperature. There is change in temperature as well as there is a force. So whatever forces you will get in the bar, it will be due to change in temperature as well as due to 10 kilonewton. So very interesting concept, very interesting question. And we will solve this question also using the same three steps, my friend. What are the three steps? Repeat after me. What are the three steps to solve problems of thermal stress? Free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. If you solve any problem of thermal stress using these three steps, then you will have no doubt in any question. Every question can be solved of thermal stress using these steps. Free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. Note this question down and then we will move on to the solution. Note this question down, my friend. Note this question down. And then we will solve the question. Note this diagram and note these values, my friend. Area 200 mm square, Young's modulus 200 gigapascal, alpha 10 to the power minus 5 per degree centigrade, delta T 50 degree centigrade. And what you need reaction at A, you need reaction at C. Okay, so note this down. All right, now let's move on to the solution. So how will we solve this problem? First we will draw free body diagram. What is free body diagram? We will remove the support and we will apply reactions. Okay, so we will remove the support at A and support at C. So if you are increasing the temperature, then this end will apply force in this direction. So the support will apply force in opposite direction. So this will be the reaction. Let's call it RA. Okay. And this end will try to move towards right. It will apply force towards right. So the support will apply an opposite force. So this will be the force. Let's call it RC. So we have two reactions, my friend, RA and RC. Now apply equilibrium equation. Summation of Fx must be zero. So what will you get if you apply equilibrium equation? There are three forces now. Okay. Remember this. Till now, there was only two forces, one at this end, one at this end. So both were equal and opposite. But in this question, there are three forces, RA, RC and 10 kilonewton. So RA and RC will not be equal. Don't make this mistake. In this question, RA and RC will not be equal. Why? If there is no 10 kilonewton, then RA and RC will be equal. Okay, if you apply summation of Fx equals to 0, RA and RC will be equal. But right now, there are three forces, RA, RC and 10 kilonewton. So apply equilibrium equation. What you will get? RA plus 10 kilonewton equals to RC. So this is your equilibrium equation, my friend. You can see RA and RC are not equal. RA plus 10 kilonewton equals to RC, my friend. Okay. Now remember this. Always put the force in newton. If you write it plus 10, RA plus 10, you might get the wrong answer. Okay. You will get the wrong answer. So don't make this mistake. It will be RA plus 10 kilonewton equals to RC. RA plus 10 into 10 to the power 3 equals to RC. Okay. All right. Now, first step, free body diagram. Second step, equilibrium equation. What is the third step? Compatibility equation. And what will be the compatibility equation here? What will be the compatibility equation? Delta L total will be 0. Compatibility equation, delta L total 0. This end is fixed. So change in length will be 0. Delta L thermal plus delta L mechanical will be 0. So what will be delta L thermal, my friends? What will be delta L thermal? L alpha delta T. Now, what will be delta L thermal? L alpha delta T. Okay. Length into alpha into delta T. So L alpha delta T. This will be delta L thermal and it will be positive because we are increasing the temperature. Now, what will be del L mechanical? Now, in order to calculate del L mechanical, what we need to do is we need to consider AB and BC separately. In order to calculate del L mechanical, we need to consider AB and BC separately. Why we need to consider AB and BC separately? Because in AB, internal force is different and in BC, internal force is different. Okay. So we need to consider del L mechanical of AB and BC separately. So it will be like this, minus of PL by AE of AB plus PL by AE of BC, and this will be equal to 0. Now why I am doing this, this you need to understand. Why I am considering PL by AE separately for AB and BC? Because force in AB, internal force in AB will be different, internal force in BC will be different. What is this P? Internal force. How do we calculate internal force? Let's say I ask you to calculate internal force in AB. Okay, we have covered this many times. How do we calculate internal force? So if I ask you what is internal force in AB, what you will do? You will consider a plane. You will consider a plane between A and B and you will calculate total force either left of this plane or right side of this plane. That is how we calculate internal force. So what will be internal force in AB? From left it will be minus RA. I have already taken the negative sign out outside because I already know that forces will be compressive. So what will be internal force in AB? Minus RA. What will be internal force in BC? You can write minus RC. From right, minus RC. From left, you can write minus RA, minus 10. Okay. From right in BC, from right RC, from left minus RA, minus 10. Okay. So you can write internal force from left or from right. Okay. So you can see that internal force in AB and BC are different. That's why I have considered PL by AE of AB and PL by AE of BC separately. Now put the values. Okay. We can take L alpha del T. What will be length? Total length is 600. Alpha, well, alpha, what was the alpha? What was the value of alpha? 10 to the power minus 5. What was delta T? 50 degree. So this is L alpha del T. Let's take this thing towards right. So it will be equal to, what is P of AB? RA. Okay, it is minus RA. I have taken negative sign already. So RA, internal force in AB will be RA. What is length of AB? 200 mm. Area is common. It is 200 mm square. And Young's modulus 200 into 10 to the power 3. So this is PL by AE of AB. Now for BC, what will be the internal force? From right it will be RC. And from left it will be RA plus 10. RC is equal to RA plus 10. Okay. So you can write RC. Or you can write RA plus 10. I will write RA plus 10. Why? Because I need the entire equation in terms of RA. Okay. So I will write RA plus 10 into 10 to the power 3. This is the internal force in BC. Internal force in BC will be from left RA plus 10, from right RC. Both forces are compressive in AB and BC. So that's why I have taken negative sign already. Okay. Length of BC 400. Area 200. Young's modulus 200 into 10 to the power 3. So this is the equation and you can see there is only one unknown in this equation. Which unknown? RA. So note this down, my friend. Note this equation and study this equation very carefully. Very carefully. Why we are separating PL by AE of AB and BC? Because internal force in AB is different. Internal force in BC is different. Okay. So that's why I have written PL by AE of AB separately. PL by AE of BC separately. Internal force in AB will be RA. From left RA. Internal force in BC from left, RA plus 10. Okay. So now solve this equation and tell me what will be the value of RA. Solve this equation and tell me what will be the value of RA. Tell me what will be the value of RA. Tell me right now. Tell me what will be the value of RA. I am monitoring the live chat. So please tell me the answer in live chat. Tell me what will be the value of RA. Solve this equation in your calculator and tell me what will be the value of RA. I am waiting my friends. And meanwhile, those of you who have solved this, please hit the like button. Give me your attendance. If you are present, raise your hand, put the thumb and like the video, okay? And share it to your friends. Don't forget to share this to your friends, my friend. We are putting a lot of effort making these videos, okay? If you want us to continue to do this, please share this to maximum number of students. Otherwise, what will happen? If we see that the video is not getting response, we might discontinue it. Okay, we will have to discontinue it if we think that students are not liking it. If you think that students are not interested, then we will discontinue it. So if you want us to discontinue, don't share it. But if you want us to continue, if you want us to put all efforts in making these videos, if you want me to solve more problems in strength of material, then share this video, my friend. And next, I am going to start a very interesting topic which students find very difficult. And that is shear force and bending moment, my friend. Okay, we will start shear force and bending moment soon after this axial load. So please share this and watch my videos every day at 3 p.m. We will cover shear force and bending moment. So it is a very interesting topic and most of the students get confused. But I will tell you concepts which you can use in every problem. My funda for solving any problem of strength of material is follow simple instructions, follow simple methods, follow simple procedure for all problems. Okay, don't get confused how this problem is going to solve. Follow the same instruction for every problem and you can solve any problem. Okay, so I will tell you very interesting topics. I will tell you very interesting concepts of shear force and bending moment which you can use to solve any problem. Okay, I will make shear force and bending moment very easy for you. And this is my challenge for you. Okay, tell me what will be the answer. Tell me what will be the value of RA. RA will be 13.33 into 10 to the power 3 Newton. 13.33 into 10 to the power 3 Newton, or you can call 13.33 kilonewton. And if RA is 13.33, what will be RC? Plus 10 kilonewton. Add 10 kilonewton. So RC will be 23.33 kilonewton, my friend. RA is 13.33, RC is 23.33 kilonewton. This is the final answer. Reaction at A and reaction at C. Okay. So you can solve this problem using the same three steps: free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. How this question is different? In this question, there was a load as well as change in temperature, both. Okay, but no problem. Whatever question you will get related to thermal stress, you can solve all questions using the same three steps: free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. My challenge for you. You can solve any problem of thermal stress. Okay. Similarly, I will tell you same concepts, very interesting procedure, very simple procedure to solve shear force and bending moment diagrams also. You can use the same procedure for all problems and all shear force and bending moment diagrams will become easy for you. Okay. All right. So this is RA and RC. So this is another type of problem, very interesting problem. Okay. So we have solved a lot of problems related to thermal stress, very interesting concepts. Now, let's move on to another very interesting problem. What problem we are going to solve? Till now, in every problem, the body was constrained only in x direction, right? Till now, yesterday, today, whatever problems we have solved, the body was constrained only in one direction, x direction. Now we will consider a problem. Let's consider a bar which is fixed in x direction as well as in y direction. This bar is fixed in x direction as well as in y direction. Very interesting problem, very interesting concept. It is fixed in x as well as in y, and I am increasing the temperature by delta T degree centigrade. Increase in temperature is delta T degree centigrade. Okay, let's say that this dimension is L. Okay, this is the length of the body. So this dimension is, let's say, L, and this dimension is, let's say, height H. Okay, so this is the problem. We have a bar which is fixed in x direction as well as in y direction, and I am increasing the temperature by delta T degree centigrade. Now, what is your objective? Your objective is to calculate the stress. In this problem, the body is fixed in x as well as in y. So you will get thermal stress in x direction as well as in y direction, my friend. Okay, note this down. Very simple concept. I told you yesterday also, whenever you are increasing or decreasing the temperature of a body and the body is free, there will be no stress. Why? Because if the body is free to expand, no load will be developed. Okay, when you will get stress? When the body is fixed in any direction. If the body is fixed, then load will be developed, and if the load is developed, stress will be developed. Okay, so you are not getting any stress in z direction. Why? Because in z direction, body is free to expand. Okay, it will freely expand in z. No load will be developed, no stress will be developed. But in x direction, it is fixed. So these supports will apply load. In y direction, it is fixed. So these supports will apply load, and due to load, there will be stress in x, there will be stress in y. Okay, so this is a problem where body is fixed in two direction, not in one direction, two direction, and we need to calculate sigma x, we need to calculate sigma y. Okay, all right. Now my friend, I will use the same concept that I have been using till now. Three steps: free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. So what I will do, first I will draw the free body diagram. Okay, first I will draw the free body diagram. So if you remove the supports, what will you get? You are increasing the temperature. Okay, focus on in x direction. Right now focus in x direction. So if you are increasing the temperature in x direction, the body will try to expand. So the supports will apply opposite load. So here and here, there will be a load like this. Okay, now in y direction, if you are increasing the temperature, the body will try to expand. So there will be a compressive load from supports like this and like this. Okay, so do you understand this free body diagram? Okay, now equilibrium equation, apply equilibrium equation. We have two equilibrium equation. In this problem, we have two equilibrium equation. Summation of fx will be 0, means this load, let's call it px, and this load, let's call it px, both will be equal. Another equation, summation of fy equals to 0. So this load, let's call it py, and let's call it py, both will be equal. Okay, so we have applied equilibrium equation. This force and this force are equal, this force and this force are equal. Okay, now what we will do? Third, compatibility equation. Compatibility equation we have to write. Okay, now my friends, what do we need? Finally, we need sigma x, we need sigma y. We don't need forces, we don't need px and py, we need sigma x and sigma y. Okay, so we will calculate sigma x and sigma y. We will not calculate px, py. We will directly calculate stress. Okay, stress is load upon area. Okay, so we don't have to calculate load. We can directly calculate stress. We will directly calculate stress, my friend, using compatibility equation. Okay, now how many unknowns do we have? Two unknowns, sigma x and sigma y. Okay, instead of px, py, we will calculate sigma x, sigma y. So we have two unknowns. So how many compatibility equations do you need? Two compatibility equation. So we have delta L total equals to 0, this is one compatibility equation. Delta H total is also 0 because change in height will also be 0. It is constrained in X and Y direction. So del L total will be 0, del H total will also be 0. Two compatibility equation, two unknown. So we can solve this problem, my friend. Okay, now we don't need to solve both these equations. Why? My friends, I told you a very important concept, a very important property in case of multi-axial loading. If epsilon x and epsilon y are equal, then sigma x and sigma y will also be equal. I told you this property, didn't I? When we were studying multi-axial loading, I told you this property, and I told you this property is very useful in solving problems. Now see, delta L total is 0, okay, and what is epsilon x? Del L by L. So del L total is 0 means epsilon x is also 0. Delta H total is 0, and what will be epsilon y? Del H by H. So if del H total is 0, epsilon y is also 0. So epsilon x is 0, epsilon y is 0 means both are equal. Epsilon x and epsilon y are equal. And if epsilon x and y are equal, sigma x and sigma y will also be equal, my friends. So I can write sigma x is equal to sigma y. So I don't have to calculate both these values. I only have to find any one. The other one will also be same. Okay, so do you understand this? I don't have to solve both these equations, del L total equals to 0, del S total equals to 0, because sigma x and sigma y both are equal. So now I have to only calculate one unknown. Okay, so now I will only use any one of these equations. Note this down, my friend. Very important concept. Note this down. It will save you a lot of time. It will save a lot of calculation time. So why epsilon x and y are equal? Because delta L is 0, del H is also 0. So if epsilon x is 0 and epsilon y is 0, both are equal. And if both are equal, sigma x and y will also be equal, my friend. So now I only have to calculate any one, sigma x or sigma y. The other one will be same. Okay. So I will use only one compatibility equation. Note this down. Note this down. And then I will solve the compatibility equation and I will find out the stresses. Okay. So have you noted it down, my friend? Okay. So if you have noted it down, I will directly solve this equation. Del L total equals to 0. So what will be del L total? Del L thermal plus del L mechanical equals to 0. What will be del L thermal, my friend? Change in length due to temperature will be L alpha delta T. What will be del L mechanical, my friend? Will it be this? Px into L by A. Can I write this? Can I write this, my friend? In x direction, force is Px. So can I write this? Px into L by AE. Can I write this? Is it right? Is it right? Tell me, is it right? Can I write PL by AE? Because there is a force in X, Px. So can I write PL by AE? No. If your answer is yes, then you have to understand this, because there are two forces, Px and Py. So length will change due to Px also and due to Py also. If you apply Py, then also length will change, right? If you apply Px, length will change. But if you apply Py, then also length will change. So length is not changing only due to Px. Length is also changing due to Py. So we cannot write PL by AE. When you can apply PL by AE, if there is only one force, then you can use PL by AE. But if there are two forces, if there are two stresses, then how do we calculate change in length? We discussed this multi-axial loading. There is sigma x, there is sigma y. So how do you calculate delta L? What was the equation of epsilon x? Sigma x by E minus mu sigma y by E minus mu sigma z by E. But here sigma z is 0. Okay. So I don't consider sigma z. Sigma x and sigma y is there equal to delta L by L. Okay. So what will be delta L here? What will be delta L here? It will be L into this. L into this. Sigma x by E minus mu sigma y by E. So do you understand this? Do you understand this? Till now, there was only one load in x direction. So we directly calculated del L mechanical PL by A. But that is only valid if there is a force only in X direction. But if there is a force in X and there is a force in Y, then we need to use this equation. Del L by L will be sigma X by E minus mu sigma Y by E. So what will be del L? L multiplied by this sigma X by E minus mu sigma Y by E. And both these stresses, sigma X and Y, both these stresses are compressive. Both sigma X and sigma Y is compressive. So I have taken negative sign common. Okay. So I will write this equation now. What will be del L mechanical due to sigma X and sigma Y? L into sigma X by E minus mu sigma Y by E. Both the stresses are compressive. Sigma X and sigma Y both are compressive. So that's why I have taken negative sign common. Okay. So this is your del L mechanical. So note this down, my friend. Do you understand what is different? Till now, there was only sigma X. There was only one load in X. So we directly wrote down PL by A. But in this problem, there is load in X, there is load in Y. So it will not be PL by A. We have to use this equation. Okay. Now, this L and L will be cancelled. You will get alpha del T equals to sigma X by E minus mu. Sigma Y is equal to sigma X, right? Sigma Y is equal to sigma X. So I will write this also, sigma X by E. Now if you calculate sigma X, what you will get? E alpha delta T upon 1 minus mu. E upon delta T upon 1 minus mu. And this will also be equal to sigma Y. So sigma X and sigma Y both will be equal to E alpha del T upon 1 minus mu. E alpha del T by 1 minus mu. Note this down, my friend, and memorize this equation. E alpha del T by 1 minus mu. Yesterday, I derived an equation for sigma X. If there is only one load in X direction, if the body is only constrained in X, what will be sigma? E alpha del T. But if it is constrained in X as well as in Y, then sigma X and sigma Y both will be equal to E alpha del T by 1 minus mu. So this is the equation which you can use if a body is constrained in X as well as in Y direction and temperature is changed. Okay. Now my friend, we are only considering example of increase in temperature. If there is decrease in temperature, you can use the same equation. What will change? If there is decrease in temperature, the forces will be tensile. So what will happen? This will become negative. L alpha delta T will be negative because we are decreasing the temperature. So L alpha delta T will be negative and this will become positive because if you decrease the temperature, forces will be tensile. So sigma X and sigma Y both will be tensile. So this will become negative, this will become positive, but your final answer will be same. So don't worry about increase in temperature and decrease in temperature. Formula will be same for both. Okay. So this is a problem where bar was fixed in X as well as in Y direction and this is the final formula. Remember this formula. So in case of only one direction fix, if you fix only in one direction, then sigma will be E alpha del T. But if you fix in both direction X and Y, then sigma X and sigma Y both will be E alpha del T by 1 minus mu. Very important concept. Note this down. So we have solved problem where body was fixed in X. We have solved problem where body is fixed in X and Y. Now I will take you to another interesting problem. Let's say we have a body. Let's say we have a bar fixed in X as well as in Y. Now we have a bar fixed in X direction. This bar is fixed in X direction. And it is also fixed in Y direction and Z direction. Okay. So it is fixed in all three directions, my friend. This time, I have fixed the body in all three directions. X, Y as well as Z direction. And I am changing the temperature by delta T. So this time, I will get stress in X. I will get stress in Y. And I will get stress in Z direction. Sigma X, sigma Y, sigma Z. Okay. So very interesting question, my friend. Increase in temperature and body is fixed in all three directions. And this question has been repeated two times, my friend. Okay. Recently, in GATE 2019, this question was asked. Okay. So, very interesting question, very important question. A body is fixed in X, Y, and Z, all three directions, and we are increasing the temperature. Now, how will we solve this question? This is the problem. How will we solve this question? Very easy, my friend. In the same way. Okay. In the same way. Just like last problem, this problem can also be solved. Okay. Now, see that this body is fixed in all three directions. Means epsilon x will be 0, epsilon y will be 0, and epsilon z will also be 0. Okay. And if epsilon x, y, z, all three are 0, means all three are equal. Epsilon x, y, z, all three are equal. So, if epsilon x, y, z, all three are equal, sigma x, y, z will also be equal, my friend. Sigma x, y, z, all three will be equal. Sigma x, y, z, all three will be equal. And what is this case, my friend? When all the normal stresses are equal, what is the stress called? It is called hydrostatic stress. Remember this. I told you in the second lecture. In the second lecture, I told you hydrostatic stress. What is hydrostatic stress? When normal stresses in all directions are same. So, sigma x, sigma y, sigma z, all three are equal. So, this is a problem related to hydrostatic stress. Okay. If you draw the free body diagram, you will get this free body diagram. If you draw the free body diagram, you will get this. There will be normal stress in x, there will be normal stress in y, normal stress in z. All three will be equal. So, this is a case of hydrostatic stress. We will solve this problem using the same concept. Okay. Delta L total equals to 0. You only have to solve one compatibility equation. There are three compatibility equations. Change in length will be 0. Change in height will be 0. Change in width will be 0. But we don't need three equations. We only need one. Why? Because we know sigma x, y, z all three are equal. So, del L total will be 0. Right. Del L thermal plus del L mechanical. What will be del L thermal? L alpha delta T. What will be del L mechanical? Now this time there is sigma x, there is sigma y, there is sigma z. All three are compressive. So negative sign will be common. What will be delta L, my friend? What will be delta L? We can use the same equation just like last equation. This time there will be sigma x by E minus mu sigma y by E minus mu sigma z by E. There will be an extra term. Last time there was only sigma x by e minus mu sigma y by e. In this time there will be another term minus mu sigma z by e, because there is sigma x, sigma y, sigma z, all three are compressive. That's why I have taken negative sign common. Okay, L and L will be cancelled. I can write it alpha delta T equal to sigma x by e minus mu sigma y and z, both are equal to sigma x. So, I can write this also as sigma x by E. I can write this also as sigma x by E. Okay. So, if you solve this equation, what will you get? Tell me, what will you get? Sigma x, what will you get? If you solve this equation, what you will get? E will come here. So, it will become E alpha delta T. And what will this become? 1 minus 2 mu. So, it will become E alpha delta T upon 1 minus 2 mu. This will be sigma y as well as sigma z. So, this is a problem. This is the stress in x, y, and z direction, my friend. So, if a body is constrained in all three directions and if you are changing the temperature, then the stress in all three directions will be equal to E alpha delta T upon 1 minus 2 mu, my friend. Okay. So, this is the solution, my friend. Take a good look at this. Note this down in your notebook. Note this final formula, my friend. Very important formula. So, we have solved all three types of equation, my friend. We have solved all three types of question. The first question, bar is fixed only in x direction. Second question, bar is fixed in x and y, both direction. And third question, bar is fixed in x, y and z direction. Bar is fixed in x, y and z direction, my friend. So, this was the third problem. Bar is fixed in x, y and z direction. So we have solved all three problem and we have derived the equation for all three cases. Okay, what was the equation? In this case, there will be only one stress, sigma x. If you increase the temperature, there will be only one stress, sigma x. And what will be sigma x? It will be E alpha delta t. If you fix the body in two direction, there will be sigma x as well as sigma y. And what will be sigma x and sigma y? Both will be equal, E alpha delta t upon 1 minus mu. And in this case, there will be sigma x, there will be sigma y, there will be sigma z. And what will be the equation, my friend? The equation will be E alpha delta t upon 1 minus 2 mu. The equation will be E alpha delta t upon 1 minus 2 mu. So I have solved all three problems. I have told you all three problems, how we can solve this problem. In this case, E alpha delta t. In this case, E alpha delta t upon 1 minus mu. And in this case, E alpha delta t upon 1 minus 2 mu, my friend. Remember these equations. You will get direct equation, direct questions based on these equations, my friend. Okay. So, do you understand this concept, my friend? Do you understand this concept? Are you liking this video? If you are liking this video, please hit the like button, my friend. If you are liking this video, please hit the like button. And if you think that you are learning something from me, please share these videos to your friends. Share this video, post this video in your Facebook. Post the link of this video in your Facebook. Forward the link of this video in your WhatsApp groups, Telegram group, Hike, whatever social media, whatever you are using. Please forward the link of my video so that any of your friend can watch the free of cost video lectures. Okay, if you think my video lectures are useful, if you think my video lectures will be beneficial, then please forward this to all your friends. Okay, all right. So we have covered all these cases of thermal stress, but still there is one more case, very important, very, very important. Composite bars subjected to thermal stress. Composite bars subjected to thermal stress. A very important topic, my friend, in case of thermal stress. Very important topic, very interesting concept. Okay, you will enjoy the concept behind this. Composite bars subjected to thermal stress. You will find the concept very fascinating, my friend. Okay. It is a very interesting topic, composite bars subjected to thermal stress. Okay, first of all, tell me what is composite. Tell me what is composite. Okay, in the live chat, write down the definition of composite. What is composite? What do we mean by composite? You might have heard this a lot of time. Composite. This is a composite material. This is a composite body. So what is composite, my friend? Tell me. Composite means a body made of more than one type of material. Okay, so let's say we have a bar which is made of steel as well as aluminum, my friend. Okay, so this is known as a composite bar. Okay, a bar made of steel and aluminum, my friend. Okay, you can consider them as two different bars, a steel bar and aluminum bar, connected parallelly. Okay, and we have fixed the ends of both these bars. We have fixed the ends of both these bars. Fixing the ends of both these bars means steel and aluminum both are attached together. Let's say this is two bodies. Okay, this is one bar, this is one bar. Okay, two different material, and now I have joined both these bodies. Okay, I have joined tightly both these bodies. Okay, so if you have joined both this body tightly, what will happen? If you change the temperature or if you apply load, if anything happens, the change in length of steel and aluminum should be same. Okay, if both these bodies are connected tightly together, if both these bodies are joined tightly together, then the change in length of this aluminum and steel bar both should be same. Okay, so this is a composite bar. Now let's say it is subjected to change in temperature. Let's say we are increasing the temperature by delta T degree centigrade. We are increasing the temperature by delta T degree centigrade. Now what will happen to this body? Okay, understand it. What will be the change in length due to temperature? What is delta L thermal? Delta L thermal is equal to L alpha delta T. Now the length of steel and aluminum both are equal. Okay, let's say length is L. So L is same for steel and aluminum. Delta T is also same. We are increasing the temperature of steel and aluminum equally. So delta T is also equal. But alpha of steel and aluminum are different. Okay. Alpha of steel is different and alpha of aluminum is different. Alpha of steel is around 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 degree centigrade. And alpha of aluminum is double, 24 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree centigrade. Okay, so you can see alpha of steel is less, alpha of aluminum is more. So what will happen? Let's say steel and aluminum are right now not tightly connected. They are just kept on one other. Okay, let's say we have not connected the bodies. Let's say the steel body is only resting on aluminum body. Right now they are not connected. Then what will happen? If you are increasing the temperature, length of steel will increase by this much. Okay, length of steel will increase by this much. And length of aluminum will increase by this much. Why? Because alpha of aluminum is more than alpha of steel. Del L is L alpha del T. L and del T is equal, but alpha of aluminum is more. So aluminum will elongate more compared to steel. Okay? This is the case if aluminum and steel both are not tightly connected. They are just loosely kept on one another. But we have connected both these body. So whatever change in length we are getting, it should be equal for steel and aluminum. Okay, whatever change in length, final change in length, it should be equal for steel and aluminum. How is this possible? We can see that alpha of aluminum is more, right? But delta L of steel and aluminum should be equal. So how will this be possible? To make this possible, there will be a force developed in steel and there will be a force developed in aluminum. The force in steel will be tensile and the force in aluminum will be compressive. So this force will take steel here and this force will take aluminum here. So both steel and aluminum will meet here. This will be the final position. This will be the final position. This will be delta L total. This will be delta L total, my friend. This will be delta L total. This is delta L total of steel. This is delta L total of aluminum. And you can see delta L total of steel and delta L total of aluminum both are equal, my friend. How is this possible? Because there will be a force developed in steel. There will be a force developed in aluminum. Force in steel will be tensile. Force in steel will be compressive. So if you only see change in length due to temperature, it will be less for steel and more for aluminum. But forces will be developed which will make change in length, total change in length of steel and aluminum equal. So do you understand this concept, my friend? Very interesting concept. So what happens in case of composite bar? What happens in case of composite bar? In composite bars, if you increase or decrease the temperature, then the change in length due to temperature will be different for different material, but they should be equal. And how they become equal? Forces are developed. In composite bar, to make change in length equal, forces are developed. So tensile force is developed in steel, compressive force is developed in aluminum. Note this down, my friend, write this down. Initially what was happening? We were changing the temperature, steel expanded by this much, aluminum expanded by this much. Why? Because alpha of aluminum is more. But both these bodies are tightly connected. So final change in length should be equal. And how is this possible? A tensile force is developed in steel and a compressive force is developed in aluminum. This is the free body diagram of this composite bar. So this is the first step. What is the second step? Apply equilibrium equation. So if you apply equilibrium equation, what will you get? Force in steel and force in aluminum both should be equal. Why? Because there are only two forces, one force here, one force here. So summation of Fx should be equal to 0. So this force and this force both will be equal, P and P. So both bars are subjected to same force. Now the third step, very important step, compatibility equation. What will be this step? We know that final change in length, total change in length in steel should be equal to total change in length in aluminum. Okay, so what will be the equation? Del L thermal plus del L mechanical of steel should be equal to del L thermal plus del L mechanical of aluminum. Okay, del L total is del L thermal plus del L mechanical. Okay, now put the values in the equation. Put the values in the equation. What will be del L thermal of steel? It will be L alpha delta T, and it will be positive because we are increasing the temperature. So del L thermal of steel will be L alpha delta T. What will be del L mechanical of steel? See, the force in steel is tensile, so it will be plus PL by AE. Okay, then del L thermal of aluminum, it will be equal to L alpha delta T, and it will be positive. Why? Because we are increasing the temperature. But del L mechanical of aluminum will be negative. Why? Because the force in aluminum is compressive. So this will become minus PL by AE, my friend. So this will be minus PL by AE. This is the final equation. You can see the final equation. L alpha delta T of steel plus PL by AE of steel equals to L alpha delta T of aluminum minus PL by AE of aluminum. Length will be cancelled in all the four steps. For all the four terms, length will be cancelled because L is equal. So L cancelled. There will be only one unknown in the equation, P. This P and this P both will be equal. Only difference is in steel force is tensile, in aluminum force is compressive. So this is plus PL by AE, this is minus PL by AE. So P is different for both. P magnitude is same, nature is different. So there is only one unknown in this equation, P. If you solve this equation, you will get the value of P. Once you get the value of P, you can calculate the stress by force upon area. Ultimately, you need to calculate thermal stress. So force upon area will give you stress. So this is a very interesting topic, composite bars subjected to thermal stress. Note this equation, my friend. Note this equation, and we will see a problem based on this. Note this question. We will see a problem based on this. Note this. Composite bar subjected to thermal stress. Okay? All right. Now, let's see one problem based on this concept. Okay? In order to understand how the problem will be solved. This is a very important concept, my friend. This is a very important concept. You will see a problem based on this concept in your exam. Okay? So let me give you a problem based on composite bar. So let's say we have two bars made of steel and aluminum. We have two bars made of steel and aluminum attached together. Two bars made of steel and aluminum attached together. Their cross section is rectangular. Okay, this is a problem. Note this term. Note the problem, my friend. Okay, you have to solve it on your own. Okay, you have to solve it on your own. So we have a steel bar and an aluminum bar. This is a steel bar and this is an aluminum bar. Length is same for both the bar. Length is, let's say, 500 mm. You don't need length because length gets cancelled. You don't need length. This is, let's say, 20 mm. This is, let's say, 8 mm and this is, let's say, 6 mm. Okay, so cross section is rectangular. What is cross sectional area of steel? 20 by 6. Okay, cross sectional area of steel, this is the area. So what is cross sectional area of steel? 20 by 8, 6. And what is cross sectional area of aluminum? 20 by 8. Cross sectional area of steel is 20 mm into 6 mm. Cross sectional area of aluminum is 20 mm into 8 mm. Okay, so this side view is the cross sectional view. Okay, so length is 500, area of steel 20 into 6, area of aluminum 20 into 8. Alpha of steel is 12 into 10 to the power minus 6. Alpha of aluminum is 24 into 10 to the power minus 6. Young's modulus of steel is 200 gigapascal. Young's modulus of aluminum is 70 gigapascal. And I am increasing the temperature by 50 degrees centigrade. I am increasing the temperature by 50 degrees centigrade. And you need to calculate sigma of steel and sigma of aluminum, my friend. Calculate sigma of steel, calculate sigma of aluminum. Okay, so this is your problem. This is your problem. We have a composite bar made of steel and aluminum. Both are attached together. You have length, you have area. Alpha of both the material is given. Young's modulus of both the material is given. And I am increasing the temperature by 50 degrees centigrade. Find out what will be the stress developed in steel and stress developed in aluminum. And I want you to solve this. And we will discuss the solution of this problem in the next lecture, my friend. In the next lecture, I will discuss the solution of this problem. Okay. So this is all for thermal stresses. We have seen all the problems, whatever problems there can be. Okay. We have even seen problems which you have not seen so far. Okay. Nobody will tell you concepts like this. So these are all the concepts related to thermal stress, and all problems of thermal stress can be solved by three steps: free body diagram, equilibrium equation, compatibility equation. This is my challenge for you. So use these three steps to solve this problem also. Okay, my friend. So this was all for today's lecture. Those of you who are thinking of joining Unacademy Plus, because already a lot of people have joined Unacademy Plus, their lectures have been started. Okay, so if you don't want to lose in this race, join Unacademy Plus. Take 1 year or 2 year subscription, because that costs very less. 60 rupees per day, 60 rupees per day only. And don't forget to use my code Apuroop10. There are a lot of people in my team. Negi sir, Devendra Negi sir in my team. Amit Dikshit sir, AIR1, they are in my team. So use my coupon code Apuroop10 and join Unacademy Plus. Take 1 year subscription or 2 year subscription and start your preparation as soon as possible. Don't lose in this race, my friend. Already a lot of students have joined. So start our preparation as early as possible. Okay. All right. So this was all for today's lecture. We will meet next time, and we are going to start very interesting topic next time. Okay. So please don't forget to like my video, share this video, and don't forget to come tomorrow at 3 p.m. Exactly. Thank you very much for watching this video, my friend.